Antarctic blue whales were hunted to the brink of extinction during industrial whaling. There's very few whales in a large ocean. So in order to continue to monitor the recovery of Antarctic blue whales, we need to develop new ways of finding whales over larger ranges. The reason that we use acoustic tracking is that whale sounds can be heard over ranges much further than whales can be seen. We conducted two voyages this year, a voyage in January and a voyage in March. We were looking and listening for pygmy blue whales, and we were developing and testing new methods for real-time acoustic tracking. We had a total of 20 days of good weather across the two voyages, and during that time we covered a 100-kilometer area along the Bonny upwelling. There is strong upwelling, which is an oceanographic process that brings nutrient-rich foods to the surface. There's lots of food for whales there that time of year, and it's a perfect place to test out new tracking methods because we know the whales are going to be there. We used directional sonobuoys to locate the whales in real time. So the sonobuoy has a hydrophone which is deployed to a depth of either 30, 100, or 300 meters. And the hydrophone transmits sound back to the ship via a VHF radio link. So we receive the sound on the ship, and then we're able to process the sound in order to get a direction to the whales. If we deploy more than one sonobuoy, then we can use the two bearings to the whales to triangulate the precise position of the whale in order to photograph and take genetic samples of the whales. We had over 100 sightings of whales, and we photographed 49 different individual whales, 25 in January and 25 in March, and one whale was sighted both in January and March. We were very pleased with the result. The real-time tracking worked incredibly well, and we're now ready to take those methods down to the Southern Ocean in order to track Antarctic blue whales.